would like to congratulate my good friend, Dr. Jerry Rosal, and I whispered to him, baka naman pwede mo rin ako maging doctor. And he whispered back to me, God is doctorate is Jerry. And when I got the same joke to Popoy, he told me, hey, I spent 6 years getting a doctorate, and I became a doctor at the age of 60. So he had one of me that as a lot of joke in the case of his, but he took this very seriously and asserted that he really worked hard for it. But let me tell you something. When Jerry was walking around in the vicinity of Quiapo, where we also saw the taller of one of the famous painters of artists of Spanish period, which was not too far from the MLQU building. I thought that his principal purpose was really real estate. Meaning to say, baka may high-rise for ECC charity. But really, I did him a great injustice. Because hearing his plans now, I can see that his plans are far-reaching and really novel. Because it does seem to me that in our country, we keep on concentrating on the usual courses. It's the same thing all over and so forth. And all of a sudden here, I hear Gandhi talking about new things, new ventures, new ideas. And really, I'm very surprised and very appreciative of the foresight of these two gentlemen. I didn't expect it. But let me tell you, so I've heard everybody speak. Let me just say that as the Undersecretary of Education was talking about K+12, this was approved when I was the Speaker of the House. And one of the reasons it got approved was that I voted for it. And the reason I voted for it was one day I was in Bangkok, a place which I had visited years ago when I was international president of the JCs, and where I saw that the education was so lousy, and the teachers were only concerned with uniforms. Believe it or not, it wasn't only the conductors of trains and buses who wanted uniforms. Even the teachers were concerned about their, and professors were concerned about looking good in their uniforms. And then all of a sudden we see Thailand, which I had looked at as, excuse me, I don't know any Thai citizens here, as being so much behind us, seeming to be surging ahead of us. And now I've also been to Vietnam, also with Jerry, in the days, in fact, the former president of Vietnam, who stepped down a few months ago, was the vice mayor of Ho Chi Minh City, when I was already president of Philippine Airlines. And so I knew him very, very well, and I could see so much progress going on there. They are now also being called a future tiger of our country. In fact, my daughter, the vice mayor of Quezon City, is in Vietnam taking a look at the housing or the low-cost housing programs that they have there. Because as you know, Quezon City also has innumerable squatters, so they were looking at doing how to do this efficiently to the satisfaction of the users, but not in great cost. So these things that you're talking about are really very challenging. And I would like to congratulate Jerry and Gary here. But in ending, let me just say something. In effect, I'm also almost a graduate of MLQU, although not quite. You know, after finishing high school, when I was 16, I started to by the colonial bayou when I was 16. Simply because the police reporter got fired for being in the nightclub while three places in Manila got burned and he was in Bayside. So the following morning, they fired him. But yeah, then he did a nasty A1, a smirk. And I found out later on, the reason they gave his smirk, he gave his smirk, was because the police were short-handed and they could not afford to fire the police reporter. But the editor was so mad, really, he looked around and saw me. I was still office boy. He said, "Can you speak English?" "Yes, sir." "Can you write English?" "Yes, sir." I was just editor in high school of the Bedlam. I have a new reporting experience. Okay, from now on, you are the police reporter. But anyway, I decided to enroll in MLQU. At the same time that I enrolled in MLQU, also for pre-law, and I know some good friends who are graduates of the law school there, like Senator Bobby Cañada, like Bert Romulo, my foreign secretary, really are honored graduates of the College of Law and MLQU. It's a high study, it started to go down for one reason or another, and now Jerry will revive it. He's really just the guy to do it. Especially Jerry, as long as his wife doesn't stop him. He's very single-minded. To go back to my story, that was also the time that I met Mayor Blackson. And so I became also a student of some of the local nightclubs together with Mayor Bill Blackson. So when working as a police reporter, around 10 or 11 o'clock, when the paper has closed, or the news was closed, we were working at 3 a.m., call me from Tarawisa nightclub and so forth. Then early in the morning, 7:30, I'm supposed to be in MLQU studying. So I have one achievement. One trimester. Where all my grades were 9 and 7. Only MLQU ever did that to me. So, naiyaman ako. Na, my God, I'm going to have a set of grades that may mga 7 and ayoko nun. So I repeated the whole thing, although I passed all of those courses, 77, 75, 78, yung makita sa transcript ko yan. So I repeated all of those topics, pero that also sobered me out. Less night clubbing, more working, and definitely more studying. And with this new MLQU, more studying ito for the right topics. Because as I said, I was really amazed when I was in Bangkok just to complete it. Can you imagine one of the officials there told me that they may have to discard Filipino teachers as teachers in the country. And dami-dami pa lang, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of Filipino teachers pala in Thailand, even in Myanmar. When I first went to Myanmar, there were only 500 Filipinos there, 250 of whom were teachers. O pagkatapos eh, sasabihin, a country that I was looking down on, for which I mentioned earlier, sabihin sa akin na hindi raw tayo qualify magturo because we are not K+12 for those 2 years. Kaya when this bill was pending in Congress, pinusto niya. I pushed it. A lot of congressmen thought it was unnecessary. Kaya sabi ko, necessary yan, kaya ko. Pwede mawawala tayo. And itong MLQU has gone home in Quezon City, the best city in the country. And looking forward to it as also one of the best universities in this city and in this country. Thank you.